Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am back today with a epic, humongous beauty haul for you guys. Most of these items, I think almost all of them are PR items. If we've never met before, my name is Chelsea. I make videos weekly on beauty, fashion, and travel, and I hope you'll join me by subscribing down below. All right, so first up, I want to start off with Armani. Let's start with a bang. This is the Armani Privé fragrance. This is the Pivoine Suzu. It's peony, very floral, but also a little bit peppery, maybe like a pink peppercorn. If you're looking for a luxury fragrance to get maybe your lady in your life for Valentine's Day, or maybe something to treat yourself with, this is a good one. This is the box it comes in. It's 100 mils, 3.4 fluid ounces. It's an eau de toilette. It's the perfect fragrance for spring. All right, so next up, my friends at Perricone MD did send me some skincare to try out. I've been loving their line lately. I've been trying their plasma face cream, which I loved, and I've just finished up, and their eye cream is amazing as well. This is their multi-action overnight treatment. This is a really nice quilted makeup bag too. It's super cute, and it is lined with their logo, and it has a pocket on the side, which is nice. So here's what the cream looks like right there. I'd imagine you could use this in place of a night cream for an exfoliating treatment. Is that what it is? It says application. Dr. Perricone recommends massaging in gentle circular motions on cleansed skin in the evening, then pat skin until the product is fully absorbed. It says add this luxurious feeling multitasker to your regimen as a treatment, light moisturizer, or sleep mask. So yeah, it's exactly what I imagine. Probably something you could use in place of your nighttime moisturizer, or you could layer it if you want to. I would just thoroughly rub this in first to get best results. So I look forward to trying this out. I've been thoroughly impressed with all of their products lately. So thank you to Perricone MD for sending this my way. Also on the topic of skincare, I did receive some products from Vine Vera, and this is a super luxurious skincare brand. Here are three of the boxes here. I really have been enjoying these products so far, so I definitely wanted to mention them in the haul. This is the Vine Vera Resveratrol Vitamin C Serum, and all these products come, you know, in this uber luxurious packaging. Opens like this, and the product was inside. Here it is. This stuff smells like orange sherbet. It is so good. It is so soft and silky going on the skin. I use this as my morning serum before I apply my daily moisturizer. And it just smells so sweet, and all you need is one pump. I've been using this for about a month now, and it's definitely helping brighten my skin and just even out my complexion. So I think that this is working wonders. This line is really catered towards, you know, women and men who want to invest a little bit more in their skincare and get really potent ingredients that are gonna help their skin, you know, fight the signs of aging. Definitely during winter, your skin can kind of look like the life has been sucked out of it. This has certainly helped put a little bit of life back in my skin, so I've been really enjoying this so far. The next product from Vine Vera that I have been trying out is the Resveratrol Merlot Moisture Day Cream. I thought I had mentioned that this is a wine-themed skincare range. Obviously, I love wine. This product comes in a jar like this. Again, super luxe packaging. It kind of smells like a spa. This is a great moisturizer. I do use it all over my face in the morning, and I use it down my neck, and it's very, very concentrated, very nourishing, and leaves my skin nice and plump and prepped for makeup during the day. So I love this. I do layer my daily foundation with an SPF on top of this, just because this does not have SPF, but I've been loving this. This is probably my second favorite so far alongside the serum. The third product from Vine Vera I've been trying is the Resveratrol Cabernet High Potency Cream. This is 100 grams, so 3.53 ounces of product. This is gonna last you a lifetime. So this product not only has the resveratrol from the wine, the Cabernet grapes, it has vitamin E, avocado oil, seaweed extract, vitamin A, you know, things that are really good and, you know, really potent for your skin. This is meant for your face and your neck area. You can use this morning and night. I find this a little bit heavy, so I've only been using it at night. Here's what the cream looks like here. This is very heavy, and even for me, I can't use this every night. I feel like my skin can't quite handle it just yet. I feel like I was using all three of these products combined, and I was starting to get a little bit of bumps on my forehead, so I wanted to like stop where I was and just kind of dial it back a little bit because my skin is so sensitive. I can't necessarily overwhelm my skin with moisture all the time because sometimes it gets a little congested. I've been slowly incorporating this into my routine, but again, like I mentioned, this has been my standout so far. but more to come on that. You'll see this on my Instagram pretty soon. I thought I'd also mention that these products are cruelty-free and paraben-free. They're hypoallergenic and dermatologist-tested, so love that, and I've been really enjoying them so far. Okay, so next up, I got some products from e.l.f., and this PR package actually was meant to get to me around New Year's Eve. It's kind of like a holiday, you know, party-inspired selection of products, but I didn't get the package until early January, so I'm still super grateful I got it, but I just wanted to let you guys know that if any of these are limited, which I don't think they are. So the first thing in the kit was something I was really excited to receive. This has been on my radar for so long, and I've just never got around to picking it up. This is the e.l.f. Illuminating Palette, and this is a 4-pan palette with some illuminating powders. I've heard, you know, for the most part, really good things about this palette. I'm a huge fan of the Ambient Lighting Powders by Hourglass, and I was hoping that one of the shades in here would be kind of like finishing powder that will help give a radiant, you know, glow to my skin without, you know, lots of shimmer. e.l.f. is a really cool brand because obviously they're affordable, but they're also cruelty-free, and that is awesome. Here's what the palette looks like right here. You have a humongous mirror and then 4 powders. Wow, I mean, those all look pretty wearable. There they are swatched across my hand. I do have some staining from some lip colors I swatched earlier, but those actually look really good. I'm impressed. Way to go, e.l.f. So I'll be trying this palette out and letting you guys know what I think. Okay, next up I got one of their Velvet Matte Lipsticks, and I think that the packaging on this was a little bit excessive. This is the lipstick and this is the cardboard it comes in. Anyways, I know these are all recyclable, so it's not that big of a deal, but this is the color Bold Berry. I actually have not tried any e.l.f. lipsticks. I've tried their blushes in the past and their bronzers, and this looks like a really pretty color. Ooh. That is really creamy and really pigmented. They also sent 2 of these Baked Trio eyeshadows. This is in Brown Bonanza and Peach Please. So there are 3 swipes from the Peach Please palette. It's a little powdery, but workable. You can kind of see it there. Let's see if the other trio is a little bit better. This is Brown Bonanza. But you know, it could be one of those things where baked products, they don't pick up so well in finger swatches. They actually perform better with a brush. So I'm looking forward to trying those out for real. I'll put them in my makeup rotation this week and see what happens. Last up from e.l.f. is the Baked Highlighter in Blush Gems. Oh my god, this is so pretty. It's kind of like this pinky bronze color. Oh, that is so pretty. It's kind of giving me champagne pop vibes. I am wearing champagne pop today, by the way. I don't know if you can tell. That looks pretty good. Again, I'm not sure a finger swatch will do this justice because it is a baked product, but I have high hopes for this one. This one looks really nice in the pan, and it's definitely the kind of shade I would reach for. It might be on the borderline of being too dark for me, but I'm willing to give it a shot. Thank you so much to e.l.f. for sending those products my way. I'm looking forward to trying them out. I haven't tried e.l.f. in quite some time, so it's good to revisit the brand. All right, so next up is Derma-E, and they actually spoil me. They send me quite a few products, and obviously, I'm very appreciative. I love them so much. They are going through a logo refresh at the moment, so this is kind of like their new packaging. I do have duplicates of some of these products in the old packaging. For example, this cleanser. I have in my shower right now in the old packaging, and this is their purifying gel cleanser with activated charcoal. It definitely detoxes your skin, that's for sure. So these products are cruelty-free, GMO-free, gluten-free, soy-free. These are also made with recyclable materials. This is a great natural brand. They're available at Whole Foods, Target, Ulta. Don't sleep on it. Really good stuff. This is their Purifying Youth Serum with Marine Algae and Green Tea. You'll see that these are all green. They're from the Purifying range. This is their Purifying Oil-Free Moisturizer with Activated Charcoal. And then finally, the Purifying 2-in-1 Charcoal Mask. One of my absolute favorites. This is a great alternative to the Glam Glow Exfoliate or Tingle Exfoliate. Basically one of the Glam Glow masks, the black one, I believe. This is a great dupe. It's way more affordable. The tube is kind of small, but it's still way cheaper than Glam Glow. So I actually just gave a bottle of this away in my latest giveaway, but this one's for me because I really do like this mask. Huge thank you to Derma-E for sending those products my way. Check them out. Like I said, Whole Foods, Target, and Ulta. Next up, I received a PR package from a brand I've never tried before. It's called Bhew Cosmetics. It's spelled B-H-U. I believe it's pronounced Bhew. And this is their Basics number one pencil kit. I believe these are multi-use. In this kit, I have six pencils. We have a shimmery highlighter, which I believe is this one. Cafe Olay, which I believe is this one. We have Universal Taupe, which I believe is this one. They're not individually labeled. Obviously, Classic Black. Wax Stay. This is actually one of my favorite types of pencils to use, a clear wax pencil. And then finally, Dusty Pink. I love using these wax lip pencils because they're universal. You can use them with any lip color. Definitely excited to have another one of these in my collection. I'm running low on the one I'm currently using, which is from OCC. I'm probably most excited to use this. I'm not using black pencil liner these days, like around my eyes. And I occasionally use a pencil in my waterline to brighten up my eye, but I haven't done that in months. So I'll definitely get back to you guys on when I use these, but the wax pencil will definitely be the first one I use in this set. I love that they included a pencil sharpener. It makes this a really fun kit and a great gift you can give to others. Knowing that everything you need is in this little cute pencil case, which you can reuse for your stationery pencils or take to school. I thought that was really cute. So this brand is actually made in the USA. I think it's really cool. So yeah, huge thank you to Bhew for sending this my way. Next up, we have a huge bag of goodies from Maybelline. This is some of their 2017 launches. Actually, before that bag came, I actually had a separate mailer from Maybelline, which was with their Big Shot mascara. It's one of their newest launches. This is the mascara that Manny MUA and Makeup by Shayla, I believe, are the spokespeople for. And it comes in this really flashy gold tube. And I actually really like this mascara. I used it out for the first time, I want to say 2 days ago. Since my eyelash extensions are falling out, I have really short, stubby, natural lashes. Typically, I don't really like Maybelline mascaras. I'm more of a L'Oreal mascara fan, but this one has a natural brush. It's pretty standard. It's got a lot of different teeth that go various different directions, but it builds on itself really nicely, which makes it a great mascara if you have short, stubby lashes, because it's really gonna volumize and thicken the small lashes that you have and then build upon itself coat after coat. So this is a really good mascara. If you're in the market for a new mascara from the drugstore, definitely give this one a go because I was really impressed. Okay, so moving on to the bag of stuff I got from Maybelline, the first thing that grabbed my attention were these lipsticks. These are from their Color Sensational Instamatte lipstick range, and these are all demi matte nude colors. And it's, you know, everything ranging from your very chocolatey nudes to your very peachy pink nudes. And the two colors that I've been trying out so far have been 565 Almond Rose. This one is 540 Peach Buff. That's Almond Rose right there. And this is Peach Buff. So you can kind of find the best nude to suit your skin tone. One thing I realized with these lipsticks is that you don't get a lot of product despite how tall the bullet is. When you pull this out, you only get that much. Like, that's like a third of the height of this thing. So that's one thing to keep in mind, but I feel like the formula is a really nice formula. These remind me a lot of the MAC lipstick matte formula lipsticks. They are pretty long wearing and not overly drying on the lips. You know, they are dry in texture, but very pigmented. They still glide on the lips, and I think they have some nourishing oils in them to help keep you hydrated. I think there are 9 total in the range, so we have a whole lot more for me to dig into. I'm not gonna bore you with swatches, but if you'd like to see a lip swatch video, I've never done one of those before, but this would be a fun thing to do since I have all the colors. Also in that bag was a huge selection of single eyeshadows. Now, I picked out the 4 that interested me the most, and the rest will probably go into a giveaway. But these are the Expert Wear Mono Eyeshadows. So here's one of the shadows here. This is in the color Nude Glow. I mean, that's decently pigmented. Oh yeah, that's definitely a color for me. That would be like a nice lid color. Just something that's gonna brighten up the center of the eye, bring a lot of depth and dimension to your eyes. This one's along a similar vein. This one is called the Glow Down. And again, pretty decent pigmentation. Okay, so it's that more goldy one right there. That is actually really nice and really smooth. So I'm pretty impressed with these so far. I need to see how these apply with a brush on my eye and let you guys know how long they wear. The other two I picked out to use are Made for Mocha and Khaki Camo. I thought those would be really nice complimentary colors to go with these shimmers. So next up in the bag is one of their new releases this month. This is the Dream Cushion Liquid Foundation on the go. This is in the shade 10 Porcelain. I only have one other cushion foundation at the moment. It's from L'Oreal and it was set in PR, but it's the total wrong shade for me. So I haven't gone out to repurchase it. It's just kind of like at the bottom of my priority list right now, but this is gonna be a great match for me. It is very, very similar in packaging. You open it up, it's a compact. You have a puff, you have a little door that lifts up, and inside, there's the product right there. Ooh, and it looks pretty yellowy, which is good for me because I have a lot of pinkness and undertones of red in my skin. So I like to look for foundations that are a little more yellow to kind of mute down the red tones in my skin. So this is gonna be really good. I might take this on my trip to Asia because I love cushion foundations when I'm traveling. I don't have time to do my makeup or a full face or a full beat or whatever you call it these days. I like foundations on the go that I can apply on the train, the bus, the airplane, whatever. I reach for products like this, and this one does not have SPF, so you'll just need to apply it with your sunscreen in the morning and be set to go. But otherwise, I'm really excited to try this out. They did set all the colors, so I will be gifting them to some of my friends who are interested. This is their Brightening Creamy Concealer, and as you can see, it's very pigmented, and it has that nice kind of yellowy tone to it. So I think this will be really good for my skin. Also in the bag was this Brow Precise Perfecting Highlighter. This is a really interesting product. It is a twist up, it's almost like identical to this product, just in a different packaging. The idea with this is you can clean up your brow area, define your arch. For this, you'll probably want something a little bit lighter than your natural skin tone. So for me, this is the best shade. Kind of see it there. This is the Master Strobing Liquid by Maybelline, and this is in the shade 100 Light Iridescent. This is a liquid highlighter, and I've already swatched this before, but I'll show you guys. This is no joke. Look how much shine and sheen that put on my hand. Do you see that? That is some serious glow. So the idea with this product is you could, you know, dot it on different areas you want to bring a glow to. You can kind of mix this in with your foundation or your tinted moisturizer to deliver, you know, an all-over illuminated look. So I'm definitely going to give this a try. They did include two other colors that are a little bit too dark for my skin tone, but they would look amazing on medium to deep skin. So this is a product to keep an eye out for if you're interested in, like, you know, the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfectors and a lot of those illuminating drops by Color FX. Kind of pricey. Here's a drugstore option that you might want to check out if you're in the market for an illuminating liquid. So definitely very excited to try that out. Another tube of the Big Shot mascara. I am really impressed. I would be curious to know if they have a waterproof formula of this mascara because that would be great for my upcoming vacations. I'm not like a huge waterproof mascara kind of girl, but it's always good to have a go-to one that you can rely on for when you need that waterproof formula. They also included some of the new Baby Lips releases, and I'm actually not a fan of the Baby Lips. I feel like the original Baby Lips lip balms made my lips peel and just blister. They did not really like that formula. I prefer a more natural lip balm, but since then they've, you know, expanded the Baby Lips line. They had the pore filling primer, they had the Baby Lips lip glosses. These are a new chubby pencil from the Baby Lips line. These are the Color Balm Crayons by Baby Lips. And just looking at these colors right away, I know they're not going to be as vivid as in the tube, but I'm going to just go for the most nude one to swatch just in case I want to use the other ones for a giveaway. It's a twist up pencil. This is kind of like a really peachy nude color. Ooh. It is very glossy and balmy. That looks like it would be really nice on the lips. A lot of the Maybelline lip products can have a Play-Doh scent. I'm definitely gonna give this a try and like at least give it a shot, but I don't wanna swatch all the other colors just in case I don't like it. So I'm gonna save these for a giveaway. These are great colorful shades, and looking at the formula, the color's pretty pigmented, but it still looks really comfortable on the lips. I'm kind of impressed at first swatch. These are the Vivid Matte Liquid Lipsticks by Maybelline, and I can already tell you I'm not going to open these. These are not colors I would wear just personally. I don't have a place to wear these to, but If you're looking for some statement lips, look at this. This purple color is intense. This is probably the darkest purple lippy I've ever seen. And this is a really cool gray. Like, if you're into that gray look, I don't think I've ever seen such on-trend, like, lip colors at the drugstore that are not, like, Halloween makeup. Like, this looks really good. And, you know, vivid matte liquid. It sounds like it's going to be, like, a liquid lipstick that's very pigmented and long-wearing. So, definitely wanted to shout those out. And if you're interested, I might have those in a giveaway coming up soon, because I just know I won't get a lot of use out of those. Okay, next up, I received a package from L'Oreal. So this is a really cute PR package, and it opens up just like this. And there are some of their new lip releases for the year included in this. So up top, we have two of the Color Riche lipsticks. I gotta say, these are kind of, you know, old school, I don't wanna say granny-ish, but these are old school classic lipsticks from the drugstore. We have two shades, Raisin Rapture and Blushing Berry. Ooh. These are actually really pretty. Now, L'Oreal lipsticks do have a very fragrance perfume scent to them. They're not going to be to everybody's taste, but I feel like these are really pretty flattering colors. I'm into it. I did get two shades of the Infallible Pro Matte Glosses. I do like these lip products. They're not my absolute favorite, but they are super duper pigmented, and they kind of give you that matte lip look without sucking the life out of your lips. So the two shades I have here are Shanghai Scarlet and Statement Nude. This is actually a duplicate. I already have this color in my collection, so this will be going in the giveaway pile. And then this color, I don't think I already have. The only other nude I already have is called Bare Attraction, and it's kind of similar to what I have on my lips today. It's a little more like nudie colored. My lippy is actually, the current lippy I'm wearing is Lychee by Jouer. But this color, side by side, definitely a lot more brownie than the Bare Attraction. So this again is Statement Nude. I do have five shades of their new Infallible lip paints here. I did get a couple of these at IMATS. I think I already have 300 Lilac Lust, and I don't have any of these other shades, but these are glossy, highly pigmented lip colors. The shade 310 in Topless, Hello Grage. I don't know if I could pull it off, but we'll see. Bewitching Bordeaux looks really, really vampy and dark. And then Fearless Fuchsia, that is really bright. Definitely like a Barbie pink for the summertime. Gonna be trying these out and maybe putting one or two in the giveaway pile, just because I know realistically I'm not gonna get around to using these all. Thank you so much, L'Oreal, for sending that my way. Next up, I want to talk about some hair care goodies I received from Matrix. Matrix, oh my god, I used to use this stuff all the time. I grew up, you know how when you grow up, you kind of like adopt some of your mother's favorite brands? They're brands that you see in the house, you grow up with. At least my experience when I was starting to get into products when I was a teenager, I'd always scope out like the high-end and nicer hair care products my mom had sitting around in, like, you know, our shower. Of course, I'd like raid her makeup bag all the time, but the hair care products we had in our house were often, you know, we had like the herbal essences and whatnot, but then we would occasionally have like Matrix Biolage, and that was a brand I really loved growing up, and it's something that's been around forever, and I haven't tried their products in a long time, so I'm super excited to share some of them with you today. So first up, the Matrix Biolage RAW, which is their Real Authentic Wholesome Nourish conditioner. I'm actually using the corresponding shampoo to this in my shower right now. That's why I don't have it to show you. But this one's fortified with coconut oil, kaolin clay, and the shampoo has honey in it. And these products are 95% natural. There are no silicones and no parabens in them. And the shampoo specifically has been really knocking my socks off, because it is natural, but it lathers just like a normal shampoo would. And it really cleanses my hair, and it leaves it fluffy, bouncy, and weightless, which is really important because I have fine textured hair, but I have a lot of it and it can be easily weighed down. That shampoo is amazing, and I'm excited to try the conditioner. The shampoo smells really good. It smells like honey. The conditioner definitely smells really good as well. You can definitely get the coconut kind of vibe in there. These products are also 99% biodegradable, so that's awesome. I had no idea Matrix had any natural products, so that's really awesome that they're doing this now, and I believe you can buy them through their website. They also sell a lot of their products at salons and at Ulta, so keep an eye out for this one. Nourish conditioner and Nourish shampoo, really been liking that. Next up from the line, I received their Recover Shampoo and Recover Conditioner. This range is more suited for dull and dry hair. The Recover range is more suited for stressed and sensitized hair. So I'll try this one out next. The Nourish line seems a little better suited for my hair, but I'm definitely gonna try this. Let's see what it smells like. Ooh, this one smells kind of fruity. To go with the shampoo and conditioner, they also sent me the Rehab Clay Mask, which is also pink. This is for stress and sensitized hair. It has honeycomb and kaolin clay. I adore a good deep conditioner, and I only wash my hair about 2 to 3 times a week, so when I need to condition it, I usually need to use a deep conditioner because I'm stretching out, you know, my hair with dry shampoo in between. It can get a little bit dry and tangly, so a good deep conditioner can keep me tangle-free and silky and smooth. So I'm very excited to try this out, and I'll let you guys know what I think in an upcoming favorites or empties video. I did also receive 2 minis of the Recover Shampoo and Recover Conditioner. I will be taking these on my trip to Asia this spring. Next up, there are 2 sprays. This is the Matrix Biolage Replenish Oil Mist. This is for all hair types. It has olive, sunflower, and Baraji oil. I think it's Baraji oil, Baraji. It looks like it's a very thin, dry oil texture. So this will be great to use again on my ends, since I do have hair that I don't wash for days on end. It can get a little dry and unmanageable. So I like a lightweight oil just to mist through the ends of my hair to bring a little shine and life back to it. The other oil is the Matrix Oil Wonders Amazonian Muru Muru Controlling Oil. So this looks definitely significantly thicker than this oil. Oh, this is interesting. It says you can actually use this in between your shampoo and conditioner in the shower, or you can use it as a finishing treatment. So that's actually really interesting. I might try that out in the shower just to see how that goes, because I've never tried anything like that before. And then finally from Matrix, they did send me 3 of their finishing style creams. We have the Blowout Skinny Queen. This is for like a, you know, a voluminous but sleek look. The Blowout Curvy Queen, which is obviously for curly hair. And finally, the Big Blowout Queen. This is for your, you know, voluminous va-va-voom hair. So I gotta say, these all smell really good. So thank you so much to Matrix for sending all these products my way. Very generous. Very excited to try the brand again, just because I've had such a long history with it, growing up with Matrix Biolage products in my shower as a teenager. So thanks so much, and I'll keep you guys posted on what I think. Next up, I received a package from Origins, and Origins, again, is a brand that I haven't used in quite some time, but I've been using their products on again, off again for probably the greater last 15 years. Again, it's a brand that my mom used a lot when I was a teenager, so I'd always like poke around her products and try them out over time. I used to be a huge fan of their Clear Improvements Charcoal Mask, but I've since moved on to other products. But you know, it's always kind of been there, and I've always been intrigued and wondering one day when I would try it again. So thank you so much to the PR team for sending this my way. Sending love to your skin. This is some of their winter must-haves. And as you know, winter can take a toll on your skin. So it's like, tis the season to pamper yourself, am I right? First up in the box is the Clean Energy Gentle Cleansing Oil. Yes, I had no idea they made a cleansing oil, and since I no longer have lash extensions, like the last 2 or 3 are hanging on for dear life, but they're gonna fall out soon, I can actually use cleansing oils on my skin again. I actually love cleansing oils, especially in the winter, because they're so nourishing and they feel amazing on your skin. So also, I wear a lot of makeup, so I need something that's really gonna like drench my face to get all the makeup off. So next up is the Ginseng Refreshing Eye Cream to Brighten and Depuff. I've heard a ton about this eye cream and face cream, this whole ginseng line, on social media. I think it maybe has vitamin C in it. Ginseng. Love a good eye cream. My aging eyes definitely need it. Next up is the Origins Make a Difference Plus Rejuvenating Moisturizer. I can never have enough moisturizers. Ooh, it smells very citrusy. It's creamy, but it's a little bit wet in texture. It really feels moisturizing on the skin. It says you can use this for AM and PM, so definitely excited to try that out. Do you guys watch Miss Holly Berry's? I feel like she talks about a lot of Origins skincare, and a lot of these names are like ringing a bell because I watch all of her videos. But this is one thing I know I've definitely heard mentioned on her channel, the High Potency Nitamins. This is a skin refining oil. So it comes with a pipette and a dropper. It says at bedtime, warm 3 to 5 drops in your palms and gently press into the skin. Follow with your high potency Nitamins cream. So I'm not sure if Holly used the cream or the oil, but always love a good beauty oil, and definitely in winter, layer, layer, layer. I'm telling you. And this is a 1 ounce size, so that's really gonna last me a long time. This is definitely the thing that's giving off the aroma from this box. This is their Ginger Savory Bath Bar. This is a hefty piece of soap. It says sensuous ginger warms and embraces your body from head to toe. Rinses easily and leaves skin soap free. So definitely will give this a try. I definitely take a bath 2 to 3 times a week, usually after I work out. So I'm always looking for nice scented things to relax with. So thank you, Origins, for sending that my way. I am really excited to try everything out. All right, and the last thing in this haul is a beauty bag I received from Bloomingdale's, and they sent me some of their bestsellers from the beauty department. And the first thing in this little bag, I've already taken it out of the box, is the Viktor & Rolf Bomb Bomb fragrance. And I'm a huge fan of Flower Bomb. It's one of my signature fragrances. I would say from my early 20s, I wore Flower Bomb from age 20 to 25 nonstop. I even have guy friends that when they go out and they smell girls who wear that, like, they'll ask them what it was, they'll come back to me and say, I was with somebody last night who was wearing your scent. Like, that's how much Flower Bomb was synonymous with me in my early 20s. So, as you can imagine, Bon Bon is almost equally as addictive as Flower Bomb. It definitely has like more marshmallowy sweet notes than Flower Bomb. So this one's a little more candy scented. I really like it, but it's not an everyday fragrance for me. Definitely when I'm going out clubbing or going out in the town, this is kind of like a sexy, flirty, you know, it's sexy, but it's a little bit young. I feel like this is going to be my new like flirty mood kind of scent. So it's very different than the Armani fragrance I talked about earlier in the haul. This is like the exact opposite, but I love it. So kind of just depends on what mood you're in, which fragrance you want to reach for. They also sent over the Dior Capture Total La Creme Multi Perfection. So I love me some Dior skincare. Dior is actually one of my favorite luxury brands, period. I would love to have some of their handbags one day. Their shoes are to die for. I was struggling to open this only to find out there's a button on the front. So it says this is a multi-perfection cream for universal texture, and it's refillable. So I think this like container is kind of fun. Kind of like how in some cushion compacts you can refill like the BB cream or cushion that lives in the middle of it. So that's really nice. I'm definitely gonna give this a go soon, but I'm not gonna open it until then. They also included a full size of the YSL Volupté Tintin Oils, and I've actually never owned one of these. I've tried them a lot at Sephora, and you guys know I'm a huge fan of the Lancome Juicy Shakers. This is in the shade number 3, Undress Me. I think it's gonna be a very, very sheer pink or sheer coral color. So I'm excited to try that out. They also sent a sample size of the Estee Lauder Little Black Primer. It sounds like this is a priming mascara. So I love layering my mascara, so definitely gonna get some use out of that. All right, you guys, so that's about it for my epic January New In Beauty haul. I'm absolutely dreading editing this video because I think I've been recording for about an hour. If you want to see any follow-ups on any of the products mentioned, please list them in a comment below. I will have everything listed in the description box with shoppable links on where to get these products, and sometimes I speak really fast, so you might want to check there if you missed something. So thank you guys again so much for watching. Please give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe below if you haven't already. And I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.